So we've seen a lot of rules for how to do data movement. These rules generally apply to most assembly code instructions, so it's worth thinking about them a little bit and making sure that we understand what makes a valid instruction and what makes an invalid instruction. So here's sort of a summary of how to check for an instruction's validity. So you need to check and make sure that the opcode is valid, and then you need to check the operands and make sure that they are appropriate for that opcode. So this involves checking the immediate operands, so making sure that you're not writing to any immediate operands, because that doesn't make sense, right? An immediate is just something that's encoded in the instruction, and it doesn't make sense to write to that kind of operand. For register operands, we need to check and make sure that it's a valid register, and we also, if there is a width suffix specified, we need to make sure that they match. And then for memory operands, we need to make sure that it's a valid addressing mode, and make sure that all of the registers used during the calculation of the effective address are all 32 or 64 bits. Okay, so with those rules in mind, here is an opportunity to pause and look at some instructions and identify which ones are valid and which ones aren't. So you should pause the video at this point and see if you can determine which of these instructions are valid. So this is yes or no on each of these. Okay, so hopefully you took a few minutes to think about that. So let's look at each of these in turn. So looking at this first one, we have a byte size move from EAX to ECX, and this is invalid because we're doing a byte size move, which is 8 bits, but we're using 32-bit registers. So that is going to be invalid because the register operands do not match the instruction suffix. All right, so here we're doing a 32-bit move from a 32-bit register to a 32-bit register. So that one's fine, that one's valid. Here we're doing a 32-bit move from an immediate, so that's okay, to a 32-bit register operand. So that's okay as well. So this value, even if it's not stored as 32 bits in the instruction, it will get extended to 32 bits to be saved in this register. So here we're doing a 32-bit move from immediate 8, which we said was okay, to a 64-bit register. So this is going to be invalid because the register operand does not match the instruction suffix. Here we're doing a word-sized move, so that's 16 bits, from an immediate, so that's fine. And we are moving it into a memory operand. So we need to check and make sure that all of the registers used in calculating the effective address are either 32 or 64 bits. And this one is 64 bits. So that's okay. There's nothing about this that indicates the size of the data that needs to be written, and so we would. This is the amount of data that would be written, 16 bits. So this value is going to get extended to 16 bits if it's not already 16 bits, and then stored at this location in memory. All right. So what about this one here? So here we're doing a 32-bit move from an immediate to this memory operand. So what do you think about this one? So this one is actually still okay. So remember that we can use 32 or 64-bit registers in order to calculate an effective address in x86-64. So this one is okay as well. Both of these instructions will have roughly the same effect unless the address is greater than what can be represented using 32 bits. So I also wanted to share a couple of caveats here. So the operand suffix is not mandatory, and technically it's only required if it cannot be inferred. So like we did in the first assembly lab, we can write just move and then, you know, the source operand and the destination operand. And in this particular case, so move EAX EDI, this is not ambiguous. So we're moving from a 32-bit register to another 32-bit register, and the compiler and the assembler can, or the assembler in this case, can infer that this is going to be a 32-bit move. And so we don't really need to specify move L in this case, although we could. And in fact, I'm going to say it's safer to include the suffix because there are some cases where it's ambiguous. So for instance, here we are moving from an immediate to a memory location. And remember that, you know, memory locations are basically untyped in assembly. We don't know what type they are, so we don't know the width. Now, don't be fooled here. The R in the RDX here does not mean we're doing a 64-bit move. We're using a 64-bit register to calculate the effective address of this operand. But there's nothing in here that requires that it be a 64-bit move. And so it's actually ambiguous. We don't know how much data this instruction is actually going to move. It could take 2 and extend it to 8 bits, 32 bits, 64 bits. We're not sure. So we would need to include a suffix to make sure that this gets extended to the right size for the space that we want to fill in memory. So for instance, if we wanted to fill a 32-bit slot with the value 2, we would use move L for the 32-bit move. So I'm going to say that generally it's safer to always include the suffix, and we're going to try to adhere to that in future labs. And I would encourage you to specify the suffix whenever you can. Okay, so here is an instruction. So think for a second about whether you think that this instruction is a valid x86-64 instruction. So if you think about this for a minute, you should be very tempted to say that this is a valid instruction. So we're doing a 32-bit move from some location in memory, whose address is being stored in RAX, to another location in memory, whose address is being stored in RDX. And on the surface, that should seem like a perfectly reasonable thing to want to do. Unfortunately, this is not a valid x86 assembly instruction. And that's just because in x86-64, most of the opcodes, including the data movement instruction, have no memory-to-memory form. So you can't move from a memory operand to another memory operand. This is relatively simple to work around. You can just copy it from memory into a temporary register, and then copy from that temporary register into the other location in memory where you were trying to go. So not a huge deal, but you know, something to be aware of.